This music doesn't have to be here still. Let's keep it on. Shalom, shalom. First and foremost, I want to give all praises, glory, and honor to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rechakodash. Double honors to my apostles and elders of Great Millstone. Salutation, much love and respect to you. I came out there pushing this word out in truth and sincerity. Now, this video is going to be pertaining to the new restrictions based upon the moronic strain that's out there. Okay, the new moronic strain. And these people are getting tired, man. They're getting tired. They're getting pissed off. And, you know, tensions are rising. Because we already know out here in Montreal, there was already a riot. From the first time they had a curfew, there was a riot. And people, you know, wreaked havoc, man. Okay? They wreak havoc out here. They got some rowdy people out here in Montreal and Quebec. Okay? So now they're reinstating new restrictions for these people. And these people are not having it. And you know, these small businesses are done. These small businesses are done, man. On top of all the oppression and wickedness that they do to these small businesses and these restaurants and these bars, forcing them to buy from them, you know, fining them thousands of dollars for little minute things that should not even matter, okay? These are the things that they're doing to these small businesses in order to what? To wipe them out. I was speaking to a business owner, this woman, you know, she was telling me, and she's always explaining to me how, you know, the different things that goes on and how basically they don't want restaurants and bars. The way they have it set up is like they don't even want restaurants and bars to be here. Okay? And that's the truth. Because they want this whole thing to end up like Soylent Green, where you got to go to them for rationing. All right? So they're squeezing out the middleman and just leaving what? Walmart's, Amazon Fresh. But soon the Walmarts are going to be done too. Because the Amazon Fresh is the new way. The Walmart is the old. Okay? Walmart represents the old world. Amazon Fresh represents the new world system, which is tied to what? The MOTB. All right? So this is what Esau is planning on doing. So that's okay, man. Yeah, these different things, they affect us somewhat. You know what I mean? We're not really into the world like that, so it doesn't bother us the way it bothers them. But it actually gives us some level of joy as well to see these people that trusted in this system finding out that this system is effing them over. You see? Because we've been telling them that for the longest. Especially our people, man. You Israelites. You so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans. We've been telling you this from the beginning. All right? And the fact that you haven't taken heed to what we've been saying, well, now you reap what you sow. Okay? You reap what you sow. And we'll see if Sleepy Joe or Justin Pretty Boy Trudeau is going to help you, man. They're not going to help you. They're all part of the beast system. They're down with the beast. Okay? So we see these restrictions coming. And what are these people doing? It says the earth fadeth away and the haughty people do languish. They're languishing. They're in a state of a depression. They're becoming more and more feeble the more and more restrictions they put on these people. And they're doing that on purpose. So that these people will beg them, will go on bended knees and beg them for a resolution, man. And what do you think that resolution is going to be? It's not going to be Christianity like some of these Israelite groups are saying. They're not going to offer you Christianity or to sleep with Edomite women. That's not the resolution they have in plan. All right? Their resolution is going to be that MOTB, man. That karagma. So that's why Esau's continues to put the strain. And the more he puts the strain, the more depression, the more violence ensues. Notice that there's all kind of records being broken of violence in these different cities, especially in Babylon. Why is that? Because all these things that's going on, all this oppression, all this witchcraft. You understand? And these people are not comforted. We're comforted because we have the Comforter. We're comforted because we have the Comforter, which is the Holy Spirit. We're not in the spirit of a deep, deep depression. You know, deep, just doom. Just your whole life is just depression, and you're ready to give up the ghost. No, man, we're pushing forward. We see the silver lining, man. They don't see the silver lining because they don't have the Comforter, which is the Holy Spirit. And if you hear an Israelite group talking about they was ready to commit, to off themselves, then you know this Holy Spirit is not with them. How can you be comforted and you're ready to off yourself? Someone who's comforted is not going to do that, all right? You know, that brother needs to read the scriptures. That brother needs to get with the right doctrine. He needs to come listen to Great Millstone, man. If the Lord wants him, he'll listen to Great Millstone. He'll get out of that feeble spirit, man. All right? Because in the times that's coming, we're going to need a strong spirit. We're going to need a spirit from on high to deal with these things. And the Lord is chiseling us in the spirit anyway, right? All these things that we go through daily, picking up our cross daily. A lot of people, brothers don't think about this, but a lot of people, if they go through what we go through and the consistency that we go through it, and the things that, the mindset that we have in this earth, and the stress that, you know, constantly seeing things that's against your spirit, or whether it be on the TV, on the YouTube, on, you know, on social media, on your coworkers, because these conversations, it burns, it bothers us to the point where we feel in our belly, man. Okay? So if someone from the world were to come and deal with the things that we deal with, they would end it, man. They'd be like, nah, F this, man. I can't take this. And they would go crazy. They would go actually, they'll go nuts. Alright? They would go nuts, man. So sometimes brothers don't realize, yo, brother, the Most High is building your spiritual muscle, and that's why you're able to deal with the things you're able to deal with, and just brush it off, man. Just roll with the punches. Because in the times to come, we're going to roll with the punches too. All right? Like the great men of old, not them sellouts, the great men of old. We're going to roll with those punches, man, whatever they may be. If we be of that number, right? Because you remember that guy who done he offed his ex-wife and his girlfriend or whatever the case is? He lost it based upon the situation. But we're all going through that. You know, his brother's going through that whole situation, getting child support and all the, you know, baby mama hiding the kids from, brothers going through all type of situations, but they're dealing with it. They're not in the mindset of, oh, let me go take them out. No. We're like, listen, we're just gonna trust in the Lord and build ourselves up in the spirit. We don't worry about that. We'll get more children in the kingdom. Our mind is to move forward. All right? But like I always say, can you imagine? Can you honestly think about this, man? You brothers in the truth, all right? And you sisters in the truth. Imagine being in this world without understanding this truth, without understanding the future of this world, without understanding the future of Yasher Allah, without understanding this. Imagine being in this world in the condition that it's in and the things that's going on, the propaganda that's going on right now, man. Bro, they're tossing these people to and fro. You ever heard about manipulating the mind? Like they speak about people who manipulate and will play with your emotions. The government is playing with these people's emotions on a high level, man. Yo, bro, just a month ago, not even like, about a month ago, yo, the same bar owner I was talking about, that woman, she was telling me how, oh, I'm so happy they're allowing us to bring back dancing. Oh man, yes, we're gonna get business, gonna go up a bit more at least. Just a month ago, they just reopened that, right? And now they're closing it. Today is closed. Today is, now it's done. Now it's done. Now no more dancing. So that's mind games. That's playing with someone's mind, bro. That's literal spiritual warfare. That's a psyop, man. But we see the game already. We see the play. We're not worried about that. We see the play. We see what Esau's doing, man. We matter of fact, we expect it. So we are not ignorant to Satan's devices. We're not ignorant to Satan's devices, man. Okay? All right? So ultimately, man, these people have got a long, dark road ahead of them. And the road is just going to get brighter. Even though things are getting darker in the world, the road for the elect is really just getting brighter and brighter and brighter until the coming of our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shai. Okay? So I just wanted to say that. I wanted that to be an exhortation. And also, man, these people are through. You know, Lord willing, I do a lesson and bring out that article, you know, showing that, you know, there's going to be a new restrictions in this area. And in Ontario, too, there's supposed to be some new things coming up. So listen, man, yeah, these people are being more and more depressed, and they're starting to figure out that things are not what it seems, man. All right? So with that, say Shalom.